Greetings, fellow gaming fans. I'm Small Archangel, and this is my Solus Project full playthrough. Thank you for joining me, and welcome back. If you were watching the last episode, you'll know that we just made it to this cave here, which has an obelisk in it. Whether that means anything very much to us or not, I don't know. They seem to be more like waymarkers than anything much else. It's also quite warm in here because of that heat crystal over there, so we're not in any danger of freezing. We've got some writing here, but Wilson is strangely quiet on the subject and won't read it. And then, yeah, the writing probably says, swim through this at your peril. That looks like molten lava or something to me. Yeah, it is actually moving. I was thinking it was solid for a moment, but it does not look good. Put it this way, it does not look like a good idea to go that way, so I'm not planning on. I mean, I guess we could punt our teleporter over to that kind of crag over there, but I'm not sure that there'd be much point in doing that, so I'm not going to bother. This game does reward people for exploration, and as such, I haven't been rewarded very much by it because I'm a little risk averse. I don't like dying on camera, what can I tell you? Our forward vector... Our forward vector is in this direction in any case. Passage, just a guess. Passageway of the Drowned, oh that's right. Yeah, I remember that from last episode. Passageway of the Drowned, nice.
Biohazard detected.
Yeah, that's not good, because that kind of hurt us last time, and there's a few skeletons just to prove it. Alright, so let's see, actually, if we can punt
out. Biohazard detected.
I don't think that's really going to work very well in our favour, is it?
Learning. Toxicity.
Okay,
levels.
Do you know what?
Critical.
I think probably just running like mad is the thing to do here. Yeah,
learning.
Just... going very quick.
Enough.
I'm nowhere near that anymore.
Biohazard detected.
I don't think I'm in a biohazard area anymore. I think we should be alright now. It's just where we get those white dangly things. Okay, let's have our torch. Lost a little bit of health there. Let's see, we can do something about that. We can use this, and that will also free up. Yeah, I should think so too. That should also kind of empty a space in our inventory. How are we doing for calories? We're okay for calories, but our water level's dropping. Alright, we've got a save point here as well. There's some campsites around, I think, so... the aliens are looking after us. Alright, save shrine, there we go. Let's see what our next deadly challenge is going to be. The Conspiracy, 1 of 11. Our Darsum's brother, Kigoni, showed us the ball once we finished work. The power sows the Skywoods like their son. He left the Hollowland where the Redwater lives. Their arrogance is tiresome. The Skywoods' arrogance. Mm-hmm, it's more than tiresome. Kind of killed you. The ball, I mean, we're not talking about the orb we followed down here. We're talking about... hello, Mr. Alien. Look, there he is. Right up there. I can see him. Do you know Morse by Aldislam? Yeah. He will have moved by the time we get to him. He'll have just gone. I can actually see him moving, so we know he's not a statue. Mr. Freaky, he's waiting for us. I feel like keeping my eyes on him and seeing where at what point he disappears. The Skywoods always return to the Red Water. Red Water. Dangerous place, a place of pain. They say the Skywoods' purity lets them withstand the heat without malaise. They say all their secrets are kept there, all their power in one place. One would want to go there and destroy them, really, wouldn't that one? They are evil and... yeah, we're not going to be able to keep our eyes on him, are we? Look! I see him walking away. Ah! The orb! Okay, the plot thickens. What does this say? Sorry, orb, I got to read this. I'm supposed to. Weka found a piece of the ball. Must have fallen from Great Mill during construction. She was holding it when Kigoni found her. His face twisted and the wind whipped round and threw her. He took her in the part away. We haven't seen her since. Mm-hmm. Okay, maybe we are talking about the ball I'm following. I don't know. Passage of the Drowned. Yeah, we know. It's a passage of the Drowned. Oh, it's the first time I've seen... that dome kind of minaret type thing on a building. There's a few alien statues on the toilet or something. Might just be sitting down, I suppose. Okay, let's see. Is this a campsite? Nice. What is that? Ooh, it's a bit scary looking. Not as scary looking, however, as those. Oh my god, they're following me! You are freaky! Oh my gosh, it's the dolls all over again, only they're actually skeletons. I don't want to stay here. The conspiracy. Yeah, that's the ball we're talking about. And I'm being followed by lots of little dead babies. Little but babies. I would avenge you if I could, if I knew how. There is no need to kill me. Look at this. That is part of the orb, right? That is the orb of which they speak. Right there. It's... Oh my word. Okay.
Dehydration.
Oh, for goodness sake, Wilson. Your timing is impeccable. We're about 2 foot from a flipping... 2 foot from a... What do you call it?
Inventory
full. Of course it is. From a campsite. Right. Take that and then we can pick that up. Alright. So, I'm not sure we can really learn anything very much from this, but I'm guessing that it's some more masks and some little babies that... Look at that. They're actually... like their heads are completely on the wrong way around and stuff. All these sacrifices. Okay, the conspiracy. The... plan is in motion. A prodigal sibling only appears an hour after daybreak and leaves at supper time. We will try to take the ball and roll it to the caves. It will be hard for them to track us there. Well, I got it here. This is a conspiracy against the Sky Ones, I guess. We can no longer trust the Sky Ones. I'm going backwards. We must save ourselves. Okay, I'm going backwards. This is not the right way around. Do they start here? I guess so, yeah, because that's 11, actually. Okay, this is 9. Oh, where's number 1? Oh, maybe it was where we came in, actually. I don't know. 7. Yeah, I think we were in the right place before. And another small child. Oh! Once we have the ball, we will force them to reveal the secrets within a great volcano with a hollow land. Any power, any tools, any resources a person could need will be there. We will balance the scales with the Sky Ones. Tonight is the night. Right, yeah, so they conspiring against them. They were probably punished for it. We have it. Immediately after sunfall, we used power blades to sever the ball's suspension cords and rolled it carefully down from the mill. Its brown, blue eye cylindricals. Won't be long before we unlock its secrets and turn them against the Sky Ones. How did they do? Dacto says that this ball has a different mark on it from the last one he saw, which was carried to the hollow land. There must be another there. The land of the red water, the volcanoes, where their power sources reside. The ball can help us. Did it, though? It opened. Dacto opened it. Something is coming. I can hear it when it becomes angry. It was Dacto's fault. The moving darkness, the moving smoke is here. Oh, crap. Not that again. Okay, so the moving darkness came out of that. Hence all the bones. Oh, great. So we're going to face that again. Looks like some heavy was dragged through here. So, yeah, we're probably going to have to deal with the darkness again. It is our nemesis. And there's all these drag marks. Okay, our forward vector is over there. And we saw the alien right here. He was right here. Is he like the only one of his kind left? Okay, so there must be some way of getting over there. I guess it's this way, maybe. There's a campsite marked over there. Right, is our forward vector over there? Okay. I want to see if I can find this campsite first. Oh, probably going to have to do a bit of teleporting there. Okay, let's teleport. Even though I'm not quite sure how we're going to get back. No, stay out of the water, please. So much for staying out of the flaming water. Great. Can't jump for toffee. Come on. Get out of the water. Out. And then I really need to go over here. So let's see where I'm at. And I don't know. I'm right in the, up to my neck now. Brilliant. Come on, get out. Can I not climb, really? Can I not climb at all? Water. 99% wet. Well, yeah. I can't get out of here, though. I'm probably going to die because I can't flaming get out of here. Okay, where's this blooming campsite anyway? It's over there. Can we just fire this? No, not into the water, please. There will do. Oh gosh, that's really cold, isn't it? We don't want to be staying there. Okay, let's go quick. We're not going to get any wetter at this point. Yeah, yeah, whatever. Nothing I can do about it now, Wilson. Oh, good lord, get me out of the water, please.
Warning. Operator, cold and wet.
Yes, thank
you. Dropping.
I had noticed. Great. Now I can't move because there's stairs. Oh, we can't possibly move when there's stairs, can we? Okay, where's this blooming campsite gone anyway? All right, I know. It's here. There's a heat crystal. We'll be fine. Just chill out or the opposite. There, see? We're fine. I'm just going to light this candle. Go. All right, chill it. There we are. Yeah, calories are okay. Stop shivering,
warning,
for goodness sake.
Operator, cold and wet. Temperature dropping.
No, it isn't. Not anymore.
Warning. Operator, cold and wet. Temperature dropping.
No, it isn't. It's gone up. Blimey, gone up. Get with the program, Wilson. Okay, so there's a couple of bits of food we can probably pick up here as well, though I don't know. Does that stack? It probably does not stack at all in any way.
Inventory full.
No. So. No. So we're done for there. Okay, I think our temperature's more or less right now, but we're still. Oh, and we need to fill our water bottles, but we're still wet. So probably do us good to stay here till we're dry. And we could probably usefully get a bit of shut-eye as well, so I'll just stand somewhere where we're at a comfortable temperature, so about 20 degrees. And that isn't what I meant. I actually meant that one, but we'll turn it off to conserve the battery. Okay, so we're going to get a bit of shut-eye, and then we'll see if we can find our forward vector after that. Wet, 29%. Yes, that's why we're staying here. Okay, so, I'll see you guys when we wake up. Okay.
Sleep quality, good.
Excellent, that's what we like. Right, we'll have a bit more water there and then we're good to go. Don't like that noise. Oh, right, looks like this is the way to go. Okay. Can we drop down there without hurting ourselves? We can't drop very far without it hurting. I've noticed this. Whoa! No. We could have dropped down there, I guess, but I didn't want to go in the water again. Not really. Not after we've just about dried off. We're... No, apparently we're 95% wet still. How in the heck has that happened? I didn't go in any water. Why am I 95% wet? Oh no, 70% wet. Okay. Right, we're gonna go this way. It must be very trippy in here. And if we're really lucky, we might face some more of that lovely biohazard and or the darkness. That would be great, wouldn't it? Yeah. Those dangly things. I don't think they're the dangerous ones. Oh, look, we could have come across here maybe, but I wanted to find a campsite. Okay, here we go. Around the mulberry bush. Let's light this candle. Hello. Oh, little, I was here. Just in case I put my torch out. It happens. Oh, wow. Look at that. Okay, what does it say? Passageway of the drowned. Still passageway of the drowned. Okay. Drowning isn't really what's happened to me recently. I've still got drag marks going in this direction. Oh, great. Is that telling us that we're following something big and dangerous? I mean, I know we're following our alien friend, but... Oh, what is that? Ah! Oh! You know what that is. Put it away! Put the torch away!
Reminder. Mission objective. Re-establishing satellite uplink, highest priority.
Is that orb, like, dangerous now? Is it going to come and kill us? Because that means that the darkness is around here somewhere. But is it in the form of that orb? Now? That seemed really quite sort of dangerous. Do we have to... I have no idea if that's the same thing. Is it now, like, searching for us and going to kill us? Don't know. I've not got my torch out because I'm kind of scared to draw attention. Okay, our forward vector's this way. And that's the way I'm going. Till I know what that orb is and what's going on around here. Is it impossible to run up steps? Is it really impossible? Oh, what's that noise? Okay, let's have the other torch out, keep us warm. There's a door there, but knowing my luck, I'm not going to be able to get through the door without a key. Absolutely, there you go, there's the keyhole, so we're going to have to find the lock. We'll have to find a key for the lock, but let's say first, so somewhere in this chamber wherein dwells something dangerous, there is a key. Right, we've got a good vantage point from here, so let's check it out from here. And... Okay, so we've got some sort of kind of big temple plaza, which looks pretty cool actually, but it looks pretty epic. We came in from that direction, which isn't very helpful because I don't have a compass. And we're going to have to search for this key. It might be in that sort of little tomb type thing right ahead of us. But in any case, before we go searching for anything, I'm actually going to set our teleport here, which will probably be confounded by, because I'll flip it and press the wrong button if I want to. Note to self, it is right mouse button, not left. That will reset the teleport. And I'll probably now need the teleport. So, we'll be stuffed by that. Okay. And that way, if we see danger coming and can't get out of its way, maybe what we should do is just teleport to safety. Okay, so here's the plaza. Now, I can't see that orb any longer. It probably went that way. I've no idea actually. There's four of these little huts. We came in that way and I keep getting danger stings and I don't know what they are. Alright, let's light this candle because then we know we've been in this one. fish. A fish and a pointed rock. Okay, and there's some water, so have some of that while we're at it. And this says, the survivor, 1 out of 4. The survivor. It came for us and it almost got me. The spectre, dark blades and gusting smoke. Oh, I know it well. I hid in my door as it passed by. Everyone else was running from it in a huge group. There are bodies. I saw the bodies. The thing came from inside it, within the ball. We all gathered and watched Dacto and his followers roll it past. A while later, the screaming began. Someone shouted it came from inside. They opened the ball. Never open Pandora's ball. It's a bad idea. Okay, now which way around this square are we supposed to go? I'm going to go with clockwise, but I don't know if the aliens really, you know. Are we following the survivor? I wouldn't be surprised if we kind of are. There's a load of these hoods, actually. But the key's got to be in one of them, right? Well, he ain't the survivor, is he? Okay, so survivor 3 or 4. We're going the right way. They go clockwise too. Okay. It's only me now. I think I'm the only one who hid here. Everyone else ran up to the shrine room. I haven't heard anything for a few hours. It's a dead end. There's nothing but a brick wall there. I think it followed them, the thing. I'll steer clear of the shrine room then. It has been 3 days since everyone fled. There isn't much food left here. I should move on and scavenge, but I'm too afraid to leave. Could look at the shrine, but the dark spectre never came back this way. Is it there? Quite. I feel it. I feel your pain. Yeah. I hope we're not going to encounter it again, but I kind of know we are. Alright, so there's a fireplace here. Yeah, I can see why the survivor hung around here. It's positively friendly compared to many other places. Okay, so we'll work our way around here in a clockwise kind of direction. Ah, now this one's got bars in front of it. Is there anything in the middle here? Yeah, I think this is... There's a lot of offerings. Precious metals and coins and stuff. So, that is probably where the key is. Can I... I don't know, is it? Let's have a look. Can we see? Well, it's like... There's some golden things in there. There might well be something of interest to us in there. Maybe we can shoot our teleport through the window. Oh, blast. Except my teleport's back. Well, once I know that we're not going to die imminently and have to leg it, I shall do that. This one's kind of a library tablet room. There's no thingies that we can pull in this place. No, nothing we can interact with here. Okay, and we're back to where we began. Right, so I think then it's teleporting through that window and then back out again. I'm going to end up... Oh, blast it. That's not what I meant. Okay, teleport. This is going to take a few attempts, I can tell. More than a few attempts, because I'm not going to be able to do it from down here. Okay, let's teleport up there. First... Now we'll try. No, a bit higher than that. Hey. Not in the window so much. No, through it. Yo. Okay. Okay, some sort of sepulchre. A lot of gold bars. Oh, more little baby aliens staring at me. Okay. But nothing else, actually. It's locked in here, but there isn't actually anything for me to take, so that's a bit strange. Better just search it thoroughly to make sure. No, I don't think so. I don't think there's anything in here for us to actually gain, so... back to the drawing board. Okay. Okay, that was a freaky noise. But not as freaky as the little skeleton babies staring at me. Now, I have no idea where that's gonna teleport me straight into the water, probably. Let's just see. Oh. Okay, Okay, where am I for a start off? Not in the water, this is good. Okay, teleport back to there. There we are. Okay, so where do we go from here? Well, I'm not entirely sure. Our forward vector is up that way, but we need to open the door, and we can't do that, so we're going to have to go somewhere else. Pretty sure we've been in there because we lit the candle. It's very odd. This one's locked, but there's nothing actually in it, and it's got that symbol above the door as well, which you would expect would mean that it would be important. I haven't thoroughly examined this massive chair. It's almost like a seat of the gods. There's a baby alien that's not looking at me. Okay, you're not interested in me anymore. Okay guys, well, I think this episode has probably been quite long enough, so we'll leave it here. There is a way through over there. I'm not quite sure how we get to it, but that might be the best way to search for the next, for this key. We can't get out of the back of here, can we? Don't think so. I haven't missed anything obvious. And we can't get up the other side of those stairs there either, I don't think. Or maybe we can, actually. Let's just take a look. Yeah, maybe that's going to be the way to go. Yeah, maybe we're going to have to hop across the rocks there and off in that direction to try find our key. But I'm going to save that for the next episode. Maybe for now, what I need to do is get back to the campsite. There's some food there or something, so we'll be fine. And I've got bottled water, so it's all good. So I'll just hop onto here and then, oops. As I say, in the next episode, we're going to be continuing our search for the key. And hopefully we won't find the darkness while we're about it. And maybe we'll see our mysterious alien friend once again. Who knows? Anyway, I hope you can join me then. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, you know what to do. Hit that like button. I'm going to get a little bit more sleep here. I think we're good for most things. Probably ought to have a drink first in order to avoid being spammed by messages that I'm hungry and thirsty and things. And in the meantime, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button. Feel free to leave me any tips, but no spoilers, please. And I will see you in the next video. Till then. Keep gaming, stay happy.